Standing in the cemetery, I just listened to the sounds around me and tried to allow my eyes to focus on the darkness a little better. Then, without warning, from across the cemetery, I heard a female voice sternly say,
"Get out of here."
I could not tell if the voice was coming from an actual human being or something else. Regardless, somebody or something wanted me to vacate the premises. I kept staring in the direction the voice came from. My eyes widened in amazement as I started to see a blue glowing light appear about 60 feet in front of me. At first, I thought it was just a flashlight, and that would explain the voice I heard moments earlier. I quickly ruled that out, however, since the light was growing ever so slightly without the sound of somebody walking towards me. I decided to brave it and started slowly walking towards the blue ambient area. As I grew closer to the light, I realized it was coming from the deceased teenager's gravesite. I was now about 6 foot from it. The light was bright yet did not blind me or hurt my eyes. I took a few steps closer and noticed that the entire gravestone was surrounded by this blue transparent sphere. The carving of Mother Mary on the headstone was right in the center of the glowing circle, with her face being the brightest part. I am not much of a religious person, nor am I insinuating that this was some sort of divine intervention, but the overall characteristics of this occurrence was almost angelic. I was now standing at the gate to the gravesite. At this point, all I wanted to do was pack up my belongings and respectfully leave. As I started to enter the area, my attention was quickly grabbed by someone or something coming out from behind the headstone. I can still see this image as clear as day in my head. A woman, white as can be from head to waist, was peering around from behind the grave and looking right at me. She had her right hand holding onto the side of the grave as she stared at me. It appeared as if she was wearing a robe with a hood. She was glowing as well, but not quite as much as what I had seen before surrounding the grave. I stood paralyzed as we stared at one another. A wave of thoughts was racing through my head. Who is this woman? How is she tied to this dead teenager? What is she doing here? Why is she looking at me? Was that her that told me to leave? I broke free from the spell I was under and started to reach down to grab my backpack. At the moment I had gripped my backpack, this woman started to completely walk around the grave.